subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. In this class, we will discuss about a point in a coordinate axis and how we use this concept in machine learning. So coming to our high school mathematics, we all know about what two-dimensional coordinate space is. So how a two-dimensional coordinate space looks like, this is how a two-dimensional coordinate space looks like. So it is having two coordinates, the x coordinate and y coordinate. A point in a two-dimensional coordinate space is given as an ordered pair of numbers. Let's take an example. 2, 2 is an ordered pair of numbers. It says that we have to move 2 units towards the positive side of x-axis and 2 units towards the positive side of y-axis. This is where our point lies. 2 units towards x-axis and 2 units towards y-axis. This is how we represent the data in two-dimensional coordinate space. So let's check how this helps in machine learning, how we use this concept in our machine learning. So consider our last class example. We are following from last two classes, we are following an example. What's that example we are following is a tip amount prediction. The data which we considered in our tip amount prediction looks like this. We are having two columns, bill amount is a column and tip amount is a column. So this data can be represented in a two-dimensional coordinate space. In our last class, we represented the data in a tabular format. This is how we represented the data. But in this class, we use it to understand how we represent the data in a two-dimensional coordinate space. Why two-dimensional? Because we are having two columns here. That's why we are considering it as a two-dimensional coordinate space. X coordinate is considered as bill amount and Y coordinate is considered as a tip amount. Let's check how we represent the data. How the data point looks like, 550. This is how a data point looks like in two-dimensional coordinate space. So X coordinate we consider it as bill amount and Y coordinate we are considering it as tip amount. So we have to move 500 units towards positive side of x-axis, and that is bill amount, and we have to move 50 units towards the y-axis, positive side of the y-axis. This is where our data point is. This is how we represent the data in a two-dimensional coordinate space. Let's take one more example. Our second example is, here we are considering three columns. First column says bill amount and second column says number of persons attended and third column says tip amount. What's the meaning of this data is a group of 6 members attended a restaurant and they made a bill amount of 500 and they have given a tip amount of 45. In order to represent this data in our coordinate space, we need a three-dimensional coordinate space. What's dimension we need? Three-dimensional coordinate space, because each column comes under one coordinate. Here we need a three-dimensional coordinate space. X coordinate says bill amount, Y coordinate says tip amount, and the Z coordinate says number of persons attended. This is how we represent the Z axis, Z coordinate. Okay, so how we represent the data, how the data point looks like? Point is 500, 45, and 6. This is how we represent the data point. Means, what this means is, we have to move 500 units towards the positive side of x and 50 units towards the positive side of y and 6 units towards the z coordinate. This is how we represent the data. Our data point will be somewhere here. This is how we represent the data in three-dimensional coordinate space. Okay, as a human, we can visualize only up to three-dimensional coordinate space. Let's consider one more example. Our third example says is we are having n columns, C1, C2, so on up to n columns. How we represent the data in our coordinate space? We need n-dimensional coordinate space. We cannot visualize n-dimensional coordinate space. So let's take some time 15 to 20 minutes and you imagine how an n-dimensional coordinate space looks like, this imagination will help you a lot in understanding the mathematics required for machine learning. Because most of the 99.9% of the machine learning algorithms uses n-dimensional coordinate space. So a data point in an n-dimensional coordinate space can be represented. How we represent that? How an n-dimensional coordinate space looks like? This is how you have to imagine that. That's help you a lot. Okay, hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your question in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates.